From this evening, I must give the British people a very simple instruction. You must stay at home. If you don't follow the rules, the police will have the powers to enforce them.
Okay, so it's Tuesday, the 24th of March, 2020. Now, this day in the life style of video is something I'd planned on doing for a while. There's a lot of rubbish circulating on the internet about, you know, Forex traders, there's lots of scams and stuff like that, sort of promoting this false lifestyle. So I'd wanted to do something, actually take you into the day in the life of a real Forex trader. And I'd planned on getting a videographer to come with me, shadow me for the day, a good friend of mine. But with everything that's going on in the UK at the minute and the world, obviously we are facing a global pandemic, that isn't going to be possible. So I'm just going to be recording myself today. Unfortunately, with where I live, the area I live, the Wi-Fi just isn't good enough. Plain and simple, the Wi-Fi just doesn't get good enough. And my whole trading setup's actually at the office. Now, fortunately, I can drive into the building, into the basement of my building. I can get an elevator to my floor where I work alone. So I'm actually relatively isolated there anyway. But yeah, I'm going to take you with me. You can see kind of how dead everything is, and I think it'd be pretty fun. It's a good time. It's a very interesting time. We're not going to have anything like this. You know, we might not have another time like this for the rest of our life. So it'll be interesting to show you how we're dealing with this, how we're trading through this, and basically how our lifestyle is. And you'll see how it changes in coming months as we come out the back of this sort of lockdown, this pandemic, whatever, however long it lasts. I'm going to assess the situation today. I may move my trading setup, I may take it home and move it into my sort of home office for the time being, depending on how bad things actually are. Obviously, I'm going to assess that as I go. But yeah, going to get on with this video and just take you along with me. So the time's currently like 10 to 7. I'm not getting into the office for the Eurex Open, as I don't trade the Eurex Open, but I do trade sort of just after the London Open. So try and be in the office for about 7:30, get half an hour, 40 minutes to prepare, and then we're going live with our members at 8:30 as well. So that's me just actually arrived at the building. The car park's pretty much empty from what I can see. Two or three cars. But yeah, so gonna go in and actually get started with the day. And hopefully we get up some interesting stuff. We've got a live call with our members at around 8:30, so not too long. And then yeah, we'll check in when that happens. So usually the absolute quickest way to tell if there's other people in the building is when we get to our floor, if all of the lights are off. Usually that means there's nobody in. The lights have like a 1 hour timer. So at this time in the morning, if they're all off, it's most likely that I'm the only one in. Yep. Since it's automatic, now switch. Tell me how it feels. So yeah, it looks like actually, for now, it looks like on this floor, we are the only one there. So I'm gonna grab a coffee and head through to our office space where we're gonna look at the chart, see what's happened actually overnight during the Asia session, and see what we're potentially gonna be trading throughout the day. We do have a live call with members at 8:30, which is in about an hour. So we'll go and get prepped for that, and I'll check in next time we're doing something interesting. Okay, so this is actually our space into the left for myself and Callum. Obviously, he has taken his trading setup home. He's going to be trading from home. He is sort of self-isolating or whatever. But for me, pretty much nothing's changing. I'm just going to sit this down. Yeah, for me, pretty much nothing is changing. We're just going to be working from here as normal until the situation sort of dictates otherwise. Now, this is obviously something we've been wanting to do for a while, and even if
this doesn't like go anywhere or it just gets posted as like a little short video, I still think it's interesting to kind of log such a peculiar time in our history, in our lifetime, because it might never happen again. So I'm gonna log it, show you how we get on. I mean, there's so many people in this space showing you these days in the life and driving around the Lambos and you know, doing Channel 4 documentaries and whatever, and it's just this like big false perception, this false lifestyle. You know, half of these guys trade demo accounts, they're on broker affiliate deals and that's how they make their money, and they live this lifestyle to sort of suck people in, retail traders. I was once there myself, being sucked in by these types of people. They live this lifestyle to suck in retail traders, to get them to sign up with a broker. They lose some money, these guys actually make money through commission, and then they get to live some sort of flashy lifestyle and they sort of rinse and repeat. So hopefully, if anything, if we can get a couple of these videos out, it can show you just the reality of being a trader without making you want to never try trading, because it's a profession that I love, and it's something that, you know, I think everybody should at least try. But it isn't for everybody, and that's the fact. A lot of these people will tell you that trading is for everyone. I totally disagree, but hopefully through these videos and a lot of the content we're going to be making over the next sort of 6 months, you can decide if that is something that you want to try out for yourselves. So I'm going to get prepped for this live call that we have with our members in about 25 minutes, and then I'll check in with you probably as that's happening. That what she told me, and how could I blame her? A small town girl, now she all famous. Maybe it's my fault, nah. Ain't like I've been living in a dark, nah. I told you everything. You might want to short from here. Right, now there isn't a lot of confluences to short from here other than the break of structure. But we do have the confluence, the prices retested a trend line just above it, and the EMA, right? And prices also retested a 61.8 Fib. So that confirms that the down move's gonna happen. We're scaling in a bit later. Okay, so I actually just got done with that 2 hour live call with the members this morning. So we went over some trades that we're actually looking at, done some analysis on all of the pairs that we watch. So we looked at GJ, we looked at Euro Pound, we looked at USD CAD, USD Swiss, Euro Dollar, and Pound against Dollar as well. So now I'm actually gonna go get cleaned up, brush my teeth, stuff like that. In the office, we can be drinking like 3 and 4 cups of coffee every single day. So it's a good idea to keep on top of the teeth and keep the teeth game strong. And then probably look to do some back testing and also work on some course material. We do have a sort of advanced trader course coming out. Bit more of an in-depth look into our exact strategy and stuff like that. So gonna be doing a bit of work on that, and now check in with everybody. Okay, so now I'm having probably the world's saddest lunch, chicken and mash, and I'm also in a couple of trades. I'm in a trade on pound yen, and I'm in a trade on euro pound. So I've got 2 positions there on euro pound, 1 position on pound yen. That's pound yen on just the 1 hour chart there, and that's euro pound also on the 1 hour chart. So looking all right. These weren't like, you know, very carefully scaled in positions or anything like that. I just haven't had the time today, unfortunately, so I just took positions, knowing what direction the pair is moving in, with a decent stop, low risk, small lot size. That's pretty much what I'm doing. I'm also editing this video that you're watching. I'm editing that at the moment. And it's pretty nuts just being in this building alone. I was actually out, grabbed my lunch out of the fridge, bumped into a few of the centre team who are like the people who kind of manage the building, and they're like freaking out. Everybody's gone, pretty much. So there's like me and one other person, one of their other clients in the building. So I think there's 2 of us in this full building, like 10 floors, and you know, thousands of square foot of building, huge, huge building, and there's only 2 of us in. So I'm just hoping that we don't get closed out, don't get the building closed down. But we'll see how the rest of the day progresses, see what happens with these trades. I may close out for like 0.5% gain, something like that, just
end the day with like 500 quid in the bank and go home on a sweet note, but I'll let you know, I'll update you as I go.
So this is something I like to do like once or twice a day, if I can fit it in. Come here, chill out, just sit back and either look out the window or listen to like a podcast or some like white noise type thing. Especially if you're in trade, if they're running in drawdown or if they're running in profit, sometimes it doesn't help to just be sat in front of it watching your P&L. Like on MT4 or whatever platform you use, it's easy to just like hide your P&L, but you can see on the charts roughly, and you know, just sitting there watching it doesn't really help anyone. And if you're down, sometimes you can make it worse. If you're up, sometimes you can start to interfere and like micromanage your trade, and that never really goes well for anyone, certainly in my experience. I do a lot of journaling, I do a lot of, you know, personal journaling, trade journaling, and I found that over time, taking a step back when I'm in drawdown and when I'm in profit usually produces a better result over time. So take a step back, sit here for 20 minutes, have a cup of coffee, listen to a podcast, whatever, and then go back in, not check any charts from a phone or anything like that, but just go back in 20 minutes, whatever happens, happens in that time, and you just come back feeling, you know, refreshed. I think it's good to try and find some mental balance. It's a very, very intensive thing, trading the markets, and in my personal experience, sometimes just taking a step back does your world a good. So I'm going to get on with this. I'm going to put in my AirPods and listen to some music, and then I'll catch up with you when we get back to the office, when we get back to looking at those trades. So okay, so I've actually just closed out of both pound yen and euro pound. I'll take you over onto TradingView and show you. So we've got pound yen to the left here, we were in longs, and euro pound, we were in shorts. Now, let me take you over onto MetaTrader on my phone. So here's the my MT4 history on the day. Just over 1.1k made. I said I would be happy to close out with 500 quid and I ended up walking away with about a grand. So really nice intraday positions, £1,152 made on the day. Really, really happy with that. And yeah, getting ready to head home soon, do a bit of journaling and then get out of here hopefully by around 7 o'clock. Okay, so the time is currently about 7:30. So been in for just over 12 hours. Decent day, decent profit as well, so that'll be on screen now, just a screenshot from MetaTrader, and I'm basically just going to get going, head home. Ordinarily I'd be heading to the gym right now, driving straight to the gym to get in a session, but obviously all the gyms and stuff are closed, so that's not possible. So it'll be a matter of going home, getting in a sort of training session at home, doing some journaling when I get back in preparation for tomorrow, and then simply rinse and repeat, do it all over again. So this has been kind of a follow-up to a LinkedIn article that I posted a few weeks back that got like a really, really good response. A lot of people wanted to find out a bit more, and this is what this has been. So if you have enjoyed it and you do want to see more days in the life and stuff like that, feel free to drop me a DM or drop it a like, subscribe, whatever, and stay in touch. Cheers. Get away from all the media. I'm human, don't you think I had enough? Claiming that I switched on her, only 'cause I hit a switch on her. She wasn't really good at keeping up.